In this video, I'll guide you through the procedure of bone scanning. In short, a bone scan is a medical imaging procedure that helps diagnose bone conditions, such as fractures, infections, and cancer lesions. It involves injecting a small amount of radioactive substance into the bloodstream, which then accumulates in the bones. A special camera detects the radiation emitted by the radioactive substance, which is used to create an image of the bones and highlight areas with abnormal bone activity. The key difference between an X-ray and a bone scan lies in their imaging methods and the information they provide. X-rays use electromagnetic radiation to identify abnormalities in bone structure, such as fractures. A bone scan, on the other hand, works with radioactive tracers that emit gamma rays to highlighted areas with abnormal bone function, rather than structure, and offers insight into conditions like infections or tumors. Detecting these metabolic changes is especially valuable in cases where structural alterations are not yet visible on X-rays. Let's now run through the procedure. Upon arrival at the medical facility, the administrative staff checks the patient in. A bone scan is unspecific. An abnormality seen on a bone scan can be anything. This is why the patient's history is crucial. There are no dietary restrictions, and the patient should not have fasted before the exam. The patient is then escorted to a room where the technologist will administer a small amount of a radioactive substance into a vein in the arm. This substance circulates through the bloodstream and is absorbed by the bones. You'll see that we use another type of radioactive substance for every procedure. In this case, we often use the radioactive tracer, technetium, and combine this with a bone-seeking compound, methylene diphosphonate. Bone reacts to injury by taking calcium and phosphate from the circulation and depositing them at the injury site as a repair mechanism. The tracer used in bone scans, methylene diphosphonate, behaves like phosphate and mixes with the normal phosphate circulating in the bloodstream. Anytime normal phosphate is deposited in the skeleton, so is the tracer. Essentially, the methylene diphosphonate will guide the radioactive material to bone, and from there, technetium will take over the job and emit radiation, which will then be picked up by a camera. The tracer is absorbed in proportion to the blood flow and bone metabolism. The more bone activity, the more accumulation of tracer there will be. If a bone scan is done to evaluate whether cancer has spread to the bone, once the patient is injected, they can leave the facility and come back to take images after a 3 to 4 hour delay. This ensures that the tracer has had enough time to accumulate in the bones. Don't worry, the tracer only emits a tiny bit of radiation and is not dangerous to other people. Many people are afraid to walk around like this because of the radiation burden on other people. Others even refuse to undergo this procedure because of their own radiation exposure. However, it's essential to recognize that the radiation involved in this process is significantly lower than what people typically encounter in everyday situations. For instance, the radiation exposure during a transatlantic flight is about 10 times higher than that of a bone scan. Before the patient is scanned, ask them to urinate to help eliminate any tracer not absorbed by bone cells. If doctors suspect an infection, stress fracture, or loss of prosthesis, images will be taken at 3 different time points after injection. This process is called a 3-phase bone scan. As the name suggests, a 3-phase bone scan consists of 3 phases: a flow phase, a blood pool phase, and a delayed phase. The patient is positioned close to the camera. The technologist will then start imaging and inject the patient. The first set of images is obtained over the course of about 60 seconds, which is referred to as dynamic imaging. This dynamic image demonstrates and characterizes relative perfusion to a particular area and is called the flow phase, the angiographic phase, or the early phase. Right after this step, a second image is obtained in the same field of view during what is called the blood pool phase. This characterizes blood pool accumulation in the soft tissues and bone. 3 hours post-injection, pictures of the whole body and a few close-up images will be taken. Abnormal bone activity will manifest as spots on the images. In cases where precise localization is challenging on 2D images, a rotating SPECT camera can generate 3D images, which can be used with a CT scan for even greater diagnostic accuracy. Since bone metastasis may not be as clearly visualized during the early phases of a three-phase bone scan, only the delayed phase is conducted. Three-phase bone imaging is very helpful in distinguishing cellulitis from osteomyelitis. Cellulitis is an infection of the skin and the underlying tissues, typically treated with antibiotics, while osteomyelitis is an infection involving the bone, requiring more aggressive interventions such as long-term antibiotics and, in some cases, surgery. Osteomyelitis is typically three-phase positive, while in cellulitis, there's increased blood flow and hyperemia in early phase imaging, but no increased tracer accumulation in delayed phase imaging. Bone scans can detect osteomyelitis weeks before changes are visualized on X-rays. Back to our patient. After about 30 to 45 minutes of delayed imaging, the patient can return home. The total duration of the bone scan typically ranges between 3 and 5 hours, considering the injection, waiting period, and imaging phases. Before your patient leaves, emphasize the need to stay well hydrated and regularly empty their bladder over the next 48 hours following this procedure. This will aid in flushing out the tracer from their body. Finally, a few hours after the patient has left, a doctor will interpret the images. A normal bone scan typically shows an even distribution of the radioactive tracer throughout the bones, indicating normal bone metabolism. Common areas of benign increased tracer uptake are at the acromioclavicular joints, sternoclavicular joints, the sternomanubrial junction, the sacroiliac joints, and the pubic symphysis. This is due to constant bone remodeling or degenerative changes. In oncology patients, bone metastasis will appear as focal hotspots on the scan. However, it's important to note that this interpretation should consider the broader context. If a patient has just had a blow to the chest, that focal hotspot will most likely be a fracture. Thank you for watching this video. Now that you know how bone scans work, you might want to have a look at my nuclear medicine playlist to learn more about nuclear medicine procedures.